Do you want to value your stock portfolio using Excel? And would you like live data feeds to continuously update your portfolio table? Hello and welcome to the Mr. Spreadsheet YouTube channel. In this short presentation, I will show you how to create your own stock valuation portfolio using Excel's stock metrics tool. The simple design is easy to follow, and you can easily adapt the final template to suit your individual needs. As usual, I will show you how to get a copy of the completed spreadsheet template later on in this video. During the course of this presentation, we will use and explain Excel's data retrieval using the stock data type. We will create our portfolio using the Insert Table tool. And we will use some conditional formatting and develop a quick lookup feature using the VLOOKUP command. And if you need any help with the commands or functions that I've used, then please do leave a comment below. I hope you enjoy watching. Open up a new workbook and from the page layout ribbon, uncheck the View Grid Lines box. Navigate to cell B4 and expand both the width and the height of the cell. We're now going to enter the name of our stock in cell B4. So type in Royal Mail and press Enter. Navigate back to cell B4 and from the data ribbon, click on the stocks icon. Okay, so what is happening here is that Excel is attempting to locate the stock Royal Mail, but it's uncertain as to which exchange your stock is listed on. Excel therefore places a question mark at the start of cell B4 and opens up a data selector dialog box to the right of the worksheet. Now, as I'm based in the UK, I want the London Stock Exchange. So I click on the select box for this option. Once Excel has correctly recognised your stock, it changes the contents of cell B4. This routine returns the full correct name of the stock, together with the stock exchange it's traded on, and also the stock's ticker code. It also replaces the question mark with a stock exchange looking icon and inserts a small notepad looking icon which appears in the top right hand corner of cell B4. Click on this icon and you are presented with a drop-down box which lists all of the data elements or metrics associated with this stock. Scroll down the list and select the price option. Excel examines the stock's online data file and returns the current price in cell C4. Click on the icon again and choose the stock's year high metric, otherwise known as the 52-week high. The new data is returned in cell D4. You can use this method to choose any of the metrics listed. Let's quickly examine the contents of cell D4. The formula in the function command line reads equals B4, full stop or point, and then 52-week high in square brackets. The equals B4 is obviously the stock name, then a full stop as a separator, followed by the metric enclosed in square brackets. Navigate to cell E4 and we will enter the next metric by typing in equals B4 and then select the 52-week low option from the drop-down list. E4 correctly populates with the 52-week low value. So selecting the stock metric is very easy. And as the online table is updated regularly, you will always have the current data. Before we move on to create our portfolio evaluation table, let's quickly examine the other important feature that this function offers. Click on the stock exchange looking icon to the left of cell B4. This routine presents you with an up-to-date synopsis of all the data and metrics associated with this stock. That's simply great. Let's get to work on creating our share portfolio and inserting the various metrics and calculations that we will require. Move the contents of the range B4 through to E4 down a few lines, such that the share Royal Mail now occupies cell B8, and then resize all the rows back to normal. Insert two columns before column C, and then navigate to B7 and enter in the heading Name. C7 becomes Quantity, D7 is Buy Price, and E7 is Price. Then, before column F, containing the year's high and low value, insert a further two lines, and then populate the range F7 through to J7 with Value, Plus or Minus, Year High, Year Low, and Plus or Minus as a percentage. Now select cell C8 and enter in a quantity of 150. And in D8, enter in cost or buy price of 196.30. The current value of this stock holding in cell F8 is simply the quantity in cell C8 multiplied by the current price in E8. So enter in the formula plus C8 multiplied by E8. The performance of this stock in value terms is shown in cell F8. This formula is the current price less the buy price multiplied by the number of shares we own. The formula is E8 minus D8 in brackets multiplied by quantity. If we have made a gain, the value will show as a positive, and if we have made a loss, the value will return a negative. Fortunately, we've made some money on this stock. The year high and year low values are there for our reference only. So skip along to J8, and here we will enter a formula to determine the gain or loss on this share in percentage terms. The formula is current price divided by the buying price minus 1. Format this cell as a percentage with no decimal places. Once again, gains are shown as positive values whilst losses are negatives. That's great. We now have the basic layout that we want. You can expand on this to incorporate other matrix and calculations to suit your individual needs. And in the next section, we will use Excel's data table creation tool to automate this process. Select the range B7 through to J8, and from the Insert ribbon, pick up the Table tool. From the Create Table dialog box that opens, check the My Table Has Headers box and then click OK. The table has been created with a header row and the first line of data. Expand the table down to row 15, and from the Table Design ribbon, select a style to your liking. Let's populate the table with our portfolio details. Select cell B9 and type in Rolls-Royce. And with B9 active, select the Data ribbon and pick up once again the Stocks tool. Choose the London Stock Exchange option and enter a quantity of 200 and a buy price of 113.96. The rest of the line is completed automatically. Do the same for the next six lines by copying the data shown. You can pause the video whilst you do this. And now we can tidy up our work and enter some totals and finally apply some conditional formatting to the percentage loss gain column such that negative or loss-making shares are highlighted. Select cells F16 and G16 simultaneously by holding down the Control key. And from the Home ribbon, click the Auto Sum tool. Now highlight the range J8 through to J15, and from the Home ribbon, pick up the Conditional Formatting tool. Then the Highlight Cell Rule option, then the Less Than option, and enter a zero in the Format Cells That Are Less Than box, and from the With field, choose Yellow Fill with Dark Yellow Text option. Now click OK, and your negative numbers are now highlighted. Let's complete our stock portfolio by creating a quick lookup table at the top of the portfolio listing. Highlight the range B8 through to B15, and then from the Formulas ribbon, select the Define Name tool and enter in the word stock. Now highlight the range B8 through to J15, and using the Define Name tool once again, name this range Stock Table. Navigate to cell B4, and from the Data ribbon, select the Data Validation tool. In the Allow field, select List, and in the Source field, type in equals stock, and click OK to save and close. Cell B4 now contains a drop-down box, inviting you to select one of your portfolio holdings. Please choose Kingfisher from this list. We will now use Excel's VLOOKUP function to extract the correct data from the stock table and populate the corresponding fields in cells C4 through to J4. So, in cell C4, enter in the formula equals VLOOKUP, open brackets, point to cell B4 and insert a dollar sign before the B and before the 4, then a comma, then the word stock table, another comma, 2, comma, then the word false, and now close the brackets. C4 correctly picks up 178 from the stock table below. Enter this same formula into cell D4, all the way across to cell J4. You can do this by selecting C4 and drag and copy the formula to autofill all the way to J4. Now, this returns the value of 178 to all of these cells. We need to slightly adjust each entry to pick up the correct column coordinate from the table below. Select cell D4 and change the 2 for column 2 of the stock table to a 3, which will now correctly pick up the value in the third column of the stock table. Now substitute the 2 in each of these formulas for a 4, a 5, a 6, 7, 8 and 9. All the way through to cell J4. Hopefully your quick lookup table populates correctly. Now highlight the range B8 through to J8 and select the Format Painter tool from the Home ribbon and apply this formatting to the range B4 through to J4. Enter a portfolio name in cell B2 and make bold and adjust the font size. Using the Merge and Center tool, merge cells H4 through to J4 and align these to the right. In this new cell H2, type in the formula equals now open brackets and close brackets. This returns today's date and the current time. Make this bold and resize the font. And that's it. You now have an easy-to-use stock valuation portfolio template that you can populate with your own stocks and your own metrics. We do hope that you enjoyed watching this spreadsheet video tutorial and that there was lots of content that you found both useful and informative. Now, if you would like to get a copy of the completed template, then all we ask is that you subscribe to our channel and give this video a big thumbs up. Alternatively, you can visit one of our channels on either Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. If you run a small business and would like to keep your bookkeeping records on an Excel spreadsheet, then why not watch our How to Keep Your Accounts in Excel video? This is our inexpensive solution for maintaining your accounting records. And finally, here is a short video to show you how to visit our website and get a completed copy of your spreadsheet template. Oh, and yes, please do subscribe to our channel.